Hello my dear students, my name is Hanumant Ladva. Welcome to Vision Academy. In this video, we are going to solve Karnataka State SSLC Exercise 9.2 or CBSE Class 10 Exercise 2.2. Question number 2. Find a quadratic polynomial each with a given numbers as the sum and product of its zeros respectively. Roman number 1, 1 by 4, comma, minus 1. Here, 1 by 4 is sum and minus 1 is product of its zeros. Here, let us write, let alpha and beta be zeros of the polynomials. Therefore, as per the question, the sum is alpha plus beta, that is sum, which is given as 1 by 4. Which is nothing but minus b by a. Now let us write the product as alpha into beta is equal to minus 1, which is equal to c by a. Suppose you can see clearly a is equal to 4. If a is equal to 4, then b is equal to what? Here you can easily find out that b is equal to minus 1 because it is transformed here, so it will become minus 1. And c is equal to, if a is equal to 4, then c by a, so this gives us c is equal to minus 4. Here if I substitute a is equal to 4, that is c by 4, if I transform this 4 from RHS to LHS, it will become, if it is multiplied with minus 1, 4 into minus 1 gives us minus 4. So that's the reason c is equal to minus 4. So therefore, the quadratic polynomial is, here we can write the general formula of quadratic polynomial is ax square plus bx plus c. Here a value is 4, you can write x square, plus b value is minus 1. You can write here it is minus 1 into x, otherwise simply you can write x. Next c is minus 4. Therefore we can write 4x square minus x minus 4. Now let us move on to Roman number 2. Square root of 2 comma 1 by 3. Again we are going to consider same, let alpha and beta be zeros of the polynomials. Therefore, as per the given data, alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, which is equal to square root of 2 is given. Next we'll write alpha into beta, that is product of zeros, is c by a, is equal to 1 by 3. So here you can clearly see that a is equal to 3. If a is equal to 3, then we can write b is equal to minus square root of 2. You can substitute a is equal to 3 in this particular expression. If I substitute a is equal to 3, it will become minus b by 3. If I transform that 3 from LHS to RHS, it will become b is equal to minus 3 square root of 2. Here we can write into 3. Otherwise you can write 3 minus 3 square root of 2. Both are same. And c is equal to, we can say c is equal to 1, because if I substitute the value of a as 3 here, c by 3, so if I transform this 3 from LHS to RHS, it will become multiplied with the numerator. So 3 ones are 3, 3 divided by 3 is 3, 3 will get cancelled, c is equal to 1. Now here we will write therefore the quadratic equation or quadratic polynomial is the general form ax square plus bx plus c. Let us write a is 3 x square. Next, b is minus 3 square root of 2 x plus c is 1. Now let us move on to Roman number 3, 0 comma square root of 5. Again we'll take, let alpha and beta be zeros of the polynomials. Therefore, alpha plus beta, as per the question given, sum is equal to 0. So that is minus b by a is equal to 0, and product of zeros, alpha into beta is equal to c by a, is given as square root of 5. Now let us write here square root of 5 by 1 we can write, because square root of 5 is same as that of square root of 5 by 1. Suppose if I say now here, if a is equal to 1, because here you can see clearly a is equal to 1, then we can write minus b by 1 is equal to 0. And if you transform this 1 from LHS to RHS, here b is equal to 0. We'll write b is equal to 0. And c is, we can determine c value, c, and here it is 1. A value is 1, which is equal to square root of 5 divided by 1. Here we can write c is equal to, this implies c is equal to square root of 5. Now we'll write, therefore the quadratic polynomial is first we'll write the general formula, that is ax square plus bx plus c. Here a value is 1, 1 into x square is x square only. Next we'll write b value, b is 0, so we are not going to write this term. 0 into x is 0 only. So here the common, that is constant term, is square root of 5, that is plus square root of 5. Now let us solve Roman number 4, 1 comma 1. Here we'll take, let alpha and beta be the zeros of the polynomials. Here it is given in the question, that is sum of the polynomials, that is alpha plus beta, sum of zeros is equal to minus b by a, which is equal to 1. Otherwise 1 can also be written as 1 divided by 1. Now the product is alpha into beta is equal to c by a, which is equal to again 1, or we can write 1 by 1. Now suppose if I say, if a is equal to 1, because here you can see clearly in a denominator a is equal to 1, then we can calculate minus b by a. So a is 1. If I transform this 1 from LHS to RHS, you can clearly see b by a is 1, which is equal to 1. If I transform this 1 from LHS to RHS, it will become b is equal to minus 1. Now suppose if I write c divided by a is 1, which is equal to 1 by 1, or simply you can write 1. So this implies if I transform this 1 from LHS to RHS, it will become multiply, 1 ones are 1 only. So c is equal to 1. Now we can write the quadratic polynomial is, here we'll write the general formula, ax square plus bx plus c. Here you can see a is 1, so 1 into x square is x square. Next b is minus 1, so that is minus 1 into x is minus x, and c is 1, that is plus 1. Now let us move on to Roman number 5, that is minus 1 by 4 comma 1 by 4. Let alpha and beta be the zeros of the polynomials here. Alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, which is given as minus 1 by 4, and alpha into beta, that is product of zeros, is c by a, which is equal to 1 by 4. Now you can clearly see a is equal to 4. If a is equal to 4, then we can substitute a is equal to 4 in this expression. So that is minus b by a is 4, which is equal to minus 1 by 4. Here minus minus will get cancelled, it will become plus. So transform this 4 from LHS to RHS, it will become numerator. So b is equal to 4 by 4. So this gives us 4 ones are 4 ones are. So here b is equal to 1. Now we'll write, and c by a is 4, which is equal to 1 by 4. If I transform this 4 from LHS to RHS, it will become the numerator. So c is equal to 4 divided by 4. So this also gives us 1. Now we'll write the quadratic equation, the quadratic polynomial. Polynomial is, general formula will write ax square plus bx plus c. Here a value is, you can see 4, that is 4x square, plus b is 1, that is 1 into x is x, plus c is 1, plus 1. Now let us move on to Roman number 6, 4 comma 1. Let alpha and beta be the zeros of the polynomial. Here it is given in the question, that is sum of zeros is alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, which is given as 4, and product of zeros is alpha into beta is equal to c by a. This is the formula, which is given as 1. Here we'll write, if a is equal to 1, you can clearly see that c by a is equal to 1. You can also write as 1 by 1. So a is equal to 1, then here we can substitute a is equal to 1 in this expression to get the b value. So b by a is 1, which is equal to 4. Now you transform this minus from left hand side to right hand side. So now it will become b is equal to minus 4. This implies b is equal to minus 4, and we want to find the value of c. So that is c divided by a is 1, which is equal to 1. So transform this 1 from LHS to RHS. So this will become 1 into 1 is 1 only. So c is equal to 1. Now we'll write the required, or you can say the quadratic polynomial is, we'll write general formula ax square plus bx plus c. Here a value is 1 into x square is x square. Next b is minus 4. So plus into minus is minus 4x. Next c is 1, that is plus 1. Hello my dear students, thank you very much for watching this video. My name is Hanumant Ladva. If you want to watch the next video, you can click on this icon. And if you want to watch the previous video, then you can click on this icon. If you want to get the latest updated videos, then you can click on this button to subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Jai Hind, Vande Mataram.